Syrians have for country.
Yeah.
I think, I compare it when I think about it, because it's hard for someone, an Australian, for example, to get their head around the depth of that love. But I have felt it when I've been in Syria, living in Syria. And I compare it a little bit to the indigenous people in Australia and their love for country, the connections to country. Would you say it was something similar to that, or would you have other words for
no,
it?
No, I identify completely with the Aborigines and with the indigenous people in Australia. Honestly, I read their books, I see their arts. I mean, they have beautiful arts. When I went to Australia, I went to a few homes of the Aborigines people, and you know, I felt that their spirituality, their attachment to the land, their attachment to the family, their values are so much similar to the Arab people. And in fact, as a writer, I always write that it is a war against the Arabs as indigenous people. And much of the time, Israeli press says that we are the last indigenous people in this region, and we are backward, and so they want to get rid of the indigenous people in the Arab world because they are backward and they want to bring modern people. So it is a war against indigenous people, and it is a war against us because we are indigenous people. I mean, just imagine, Susan, how much Australia has lost by wiping out almost so much of the indigenous people. How much the US has lost by wiping out a whole culture, a whole way of life, a whole way of thinking. I mean, it's absolutely incredible loss for humanity, for the entire humanity. In fact, when I appear on television, I put the motto of the Aborigines, I wear it. Tim Anderson brought it to me, and I put in my home paintings by Aborigines women, because it's just the love for humanity that I have for them. And I think the West should remember that what they did in North America and Latin America against indigenous people is so terrible. When I see now Evo Morales of Bolivia wearing the old, you know, passion, the clothes of the indigenous people, I say God created us to be different, to enjoy the difference with each other. Why should anybody try to eliminate one beautiful image that God gave us and make the world look the same? Or you know, it's not interesting really for the world to look the same. I also met indigenous people from Minnesota, University, and they told me stories about the misinformation campaign against them. For example, one story that shocked me, the American press would show them as if they are crazy because they dance around the buffalo before they kill the buffalo to eat. And of course, the Americans shot millions of buffaloes from their cars. And this indigenous professor at Minnesota University told me that we dance around the buffalo because we apologize from the buffalo, that we have to kill him or her, whatever, in order to eat. And that's why we use every single piece until the last feather of the buffalo. So it is a ritual that we respect the soul of the buffalo, and we apologize from it before we slaughter the buffalo because we have to eat. I mean, this is so civilized. This is civilized, you know. This is culture. And so, yes, I especially, Susan, during this war, they focused on destroying essential parts of our identity. Palmyra, old places, significant old places, libraries, schools, you know, any synagogue. The Jewish synagogue in Jobar is known to be the eldest synagogue in the world, with manuscripts. They destroyed or stole everything. And so honestly, during this war, I felt, even in Iraq, Namrud, they destroyed Namrud. They destroyed things that were done thousands of years ago, which are part of our identity. I don't know whether you know the old markets of Aleppo. I mean, this was their first victim. They destroyed all the old markets of Aleppo. So I had a very strong feeling that it was a war on identity. They want to wipe out our identity and to plant another identity that has nothing to do with us as indigenous people. And that's why now we are documenting our crafts, we are documenting our food, we are documenting our old places, we are documenting everything because we feel the threat to our identity. We feel there's someone who's coming who wants to erase our identity, and we want to this identity to stay rooted and to for our children and the grandchildren to inherit it from us.